Hello world, Dr. 007, and in today's video, I was showing you guys a Windows 8 theme review called Equinox. Now before I start, I'd like to tell you guys, Windows 8 themes only work for Windows 8, Windows 7 themes only work for Windows 7. I had someone message me saying they tried this theme, it completely destroyed their computer, they can't even log on. Well, that was because they used the Windows 7 theme on a Windows 8 machine. Windows 8, Windows 7, although it's similar, are not the same. The themes do not work for both of them. They work for one. So like this video right here, this theme will not work on Windows 7 machines. Also, some people have been asking me why I have a ditch to Windows 8. Well, I have a couple answers to you. First of all, a lot of people are complaining I wasn't doing Windows 7. So I'm trying to make both worlds happy here. I'm trying to do some Windows 7, some Windows 8. And I'm trying to also do tutorials that are in between, that work for both Windows 7 users and Windows 8 users, because I feel if I can do that, then that keeps both sides happy. Obviously, I have some videos that are going to be just towards Windows 7 or just towards Windows 8, like this video right here, and I can't make both happy. So, I try my best. Now, like I said before, if it says Windows 7 in the video, it only works for Windows 7. If it says Windows 8, it only works for Windows 8. So let's get started. So to find out which file you need down below, go ahead and open up this Explorer, go to your computer button here, and click the System Properties. Right next to System Type, where it says 64-bit or 32-bit, whatever it says, write that down or memorize it, and go below into the video description and click the Download button next to your number. So it's going to say 64-bit download, 32-bit download. If yours says 64, go down the 64 one. If yours says 32-bit, then go down the 32-bit one. Once you download yours, continue on the tutorial. So I've already downloaded the one that I need, which is this one right here. Once you've downloaded it and you're ready to start, go ahead and double-click it. You may need the UAC control to approve it, so that may require a administration password. So once you've opened this up, you can go ahead and click Next. I accept. Next. You can get rid of this bottom bar and all these bars here. Click Next. And then you can go ahead and choose what you want. I suggest keeping everything checked. This just makes sure that you work properly. Let's go ahead and click Install. It should take not too long, but it will do its thing. Now, while this is installing, I have to ask you guys, you should tell right now that it is zoomed in. I did this new thing with some new editing where I'm going to zoom in more often and kind of give the little arrows and stuff. I'd like to know how you guys like this, and if you like it at all, leave it below. Anyways, guys, now that it's done, all you got to do is click Reboot Now, and it will root. And I will continue recording once it has finished restarting. Alright, so I am back with our Equinox looking desktop. As you can tell, it's a really cool look. It comes with one wallpaper, and obviously you can switch it to your own. So if you have your own off Google or whatever, just right click it. Hey, it says desktop background, and you can change that. Along with our custom, we have a custom pointer, so we can click stuff. It also bleeps a bit. We also have this custom Mac dock, as you can tell, with works too, all the way, by the way, so clicking on it works fine. To adjust its settings, you can right-click on it and click Dock Settings, and from there you can choose your icons, you can change how much it zooms in. So you can mess with these settings and choose the one that you prefer the most. To add an icon to Rocket Dock, all you gotta do is find a folder or a file and just drag it up there, and once it gets to up there and it separates, then open, let go. That app instantly gets added there. If you want to get rid of it, just pull it off, let go, and it puffs away. So, obviously we have our custom icons. Now for you guys, you may not get the custom icons right away. And you could wait for the next time your computer to refresh your icons, or you can manually do it using the application built in. Now if you're going to do this manually, make sure you watch correctly so you don't mess up and have to restart your computer. So what you're going to want to do is make sure Rocket Dock is open. Okay, keep Rocket Dock open during this process. go to the start screen and type in refresh. And refresh icon catch, it's right there. Click on that. And what it's going to do is it's instantly going to blank your screen and leave you with this no, nothing really. From here, go up to the top here, click computer. This will open up and you should see that your icons have been applied everywhere. So all your folders. Now to reopen Explorer and back to your normal again, go to the computer, open up your C drive, open up the Windows folder, press E on your keyboard a couple times, and you should get to Explorer, open up Explorer, and then boom, everything should come back into place after a couple seconds. So besides that guys, that's about it for this video. Like I said, we have the custom icons, we have the custom forward and back buttons, close, maximize, and minimize buttons. The icons even go all the way up to our control panel, which you can see here. Another great thing with this skin pack, guys, is this right here. When you get tired of this look, go to your uninstall program, press E, and Equinox Skin Pack Beta, double-click that, and you can go ahead, click all of them, all the way down, click uninstall, and it will go away completely after you restart your computer. Anyways guys, that's it for this video. Hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, drop a like. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave the comment below and I will try and answer your question as best as I can. Anyways guys, that's it for this video. Hope you liked it and I'll see you in my next one. This is Tacker007 and I'm signing off.